It's my birthday, and I'm just gonna play some dumb shit. Give me just a second to get some stuff set up.
Playing anything in particular order today, and I'm not even going to promise I'll be finishing any of these. Okay, that's better. I can't promise I'm going to be finishing any of these, and oh Jesus. So, I got this for my birthday a couple years ago. Maybe like, I turned 28 today, so I got this maybe when I was like 13 or 14. This game was hard as shit. It took me like a full year to beat this. And this is also my first time using Dolphin. I set this up just to do this. Just to do my birthday bash, but if there are any settings anyone is aware of that I need to change, please let me know.
Nope. That ain't gonna work.
Okay, I'll quit fucking around, I promise. Be a lot of Mega Man today because I've gotten a lot of Mega Man for my birthdays. Shit. Okay. So, I don't know for sure if this game was hard just because I was a stupid kid, or if this game was legitimately fucking hard, but we will play it as long as we can. As long as... Basically, the flow of today is gonna be until I get fucking bored. Yep. All right, first rabbit of the stream, first dead rabbit of the stream. Stupid thing was in every Mega Man game at the time. Oh shit, those were bars. Oh well, we can come back. Someone is probably fucking screaming at me right now, but oh well. It's gonna be real fucking casual today. I'm not gonna give a shit about nothing. I always liked this game as a kid because the GameCube disc actually looked like LAN and Mega Man's signal or sigil. Oh shit! Oh god, now I gotta use the shitty buster. Oh, rabbit! Rabbit, no, I'm your friend! Shit. The Battle Network toys. I probably played with them a lot longer than I should have, you know. Oh shit. I always joke around that Chris O'Neill is my spirit animal. Because listening to the Sleepy Cabin podcast and just keeping up with Newgrounds like I used to do. Every time Chris would tell a story, it's just like, are we long lost twins? So this is what was always really cool about network transmission. They shit. Nope. The models in this game did not look well. I don't think they were ever meant to be seen in, what did I set to Z? Okay. But as you can see, it's kind of the actual fireman level from Eggman 1. Whoa, hey! Buster is so fucking garbage in this game because you have to get, like, a certain rhythm going. I kinda like Mega Man EXE's design just because it's the most cosplay friendly, and I don't have to walk around in Superman underwear. There does get to a point where your Buster is better than the actual Buster, or any of the chips you can get. Hey, it's Friender. Yo mama! Well, that's fucking useless. Pro fucking strats right here. Oh, thank you. Sorry. I was trying to look over onto my monitor I'm playing on. Bop. Okay. And I have nothing to throw at you. I used to play this like such a pussy when I was a kid. I'd be stacked up with like half healing items and half cannons. I don't think I ever did anything else. The The EXE redesigns for me were always hit or miss. Sometimes they were really cool, and then sometimes they were really fucking stupid. Like, Pharaoh Man is one of the worst. It's like he's literally just the coffin. And they tried to play him up as, like, the big Frieza villain for, like, an entire arc. I've got this, like, shitty... Well, I can't say that. It's actually kind of fun. I played it a lot. But I've got this, like, weird D&D ripoff Mega Man EXE game where, like, the main villain is Pharaoh Man, and it's this big, cool coffin you just put in the middle of the board. Ah! And that's why this game blows ass! Good. This is a good setup. Another good one. Oh, what have you done? What have you done? Okay, hold on. Okay. I played the shit out of this as a kid. Let's do some good old fashioned. Where's it at? Oh, that's cool. I forgot about that little room. Oh yeah, I remember this boy. It always cracked me up when I was a kid because I always thought the map in the lower left looked like fucking Hamtaro. So this game is kind of ubiquitous amongst GameCube owners, and this is just straight up. Fuck yeah! Oh yeah. Give it to me. Give it to me, Neil. As I like skirt past everything and I don't fucking care. My friends and I would fuck around in the multiplayer mode for City Trial nonstop. And I used to love just going into free trial and just fucking around. Probably do some of that too. But yeah, if you're a poor child who never got to shit, if you never got to play this game, I'm so sorry. Ooh, the popper. Ooh, the popper. No, I wanted the pop. Oh shit. Oops. But you play this game with one button, the A button. There's like a moped too, and that moped's awesome. I used to kick the shit out of things in the moped. Like anytime you get that jump, like put a bunch of glide and jump, like weightlessness onto your fucking moped, you will jump like through the fucking air forever. I remember that lower right run being really cool too. I think the gimmick was like, you had really good control while you were boosting. Oops. Ow. Oh shit. Oh. Okay, I can hop my dead body around. Let's do free run. What is this? Okay. Now this is the one I always used to play with. And there's a garage down here. Where is it at? I want to say this has to be like a beta that they just let you play with. I don't know if you could ever officially unlock this. But you can just fly for goddamn ever in this thing. There's like a UFO, let's fly to the top. Like my first time replaying this in years, you'll have to give me some credit here. I feel like City Trial was just the test bed for like a proper 3D Kirby. Oh, you can't play with the Well, that's too bad. Hurrah, Chinese delivery! Stick is either too loose or too good for the GameCube. I can't do. I think this boxy one was good for, like, if you built this thing up as defense, it was a really good fucking tank. Because I know I had an asshole friend who, like, He would always go for the same build every time, so he would either absolutely kick my fucking teeth in, or, hello? Oh. Stick around just a couple more. This one was awesome. It always goes top speed, but you have to totally stop it in order to turn. See? Yep. The best thing to do was to always seek this one out and then try to build up as much turn as you could. Because then you actually would be able to turn with this thing. And of course, you can turn while gliding. That would be ridiculous. Can't glide for shit, though. And this one's like this weird surfboard that builds up as you... I always feel like this was just... This could have been anything. It didn't have to be Kirby. But just the fact that it was Kirby made it so much better. Hold up. I think this is the Glide Star. Yeah, the thing with the wings may be the Glide Star. I don't know. Yeah, if you played Smash Run in Super Smash Bros. 3DS, this is what Smash Run was based off of. This fantastic game right here. But games I've gotten for my birthday can't all be fucking winners. So let's look at some of the less than ideal games that I've gotten. The kind of shit that Grandma sees in the bin at Target and goes, "Hey, this is good." Oh man, do I gotta do this every time? Come on now. This is another one that I haven't played for years, so we could be... This could be better than I remember, but this was one of those games that just kind of slowly weighed its way back to my shelf and never came back. What kind of extras do you have? Shit, yeah! This is a real party now! Yeah! Yeah, redneck soap operas! I'm in this! Okay, there goes the copyright strike. I feel like I know them more through osmosis than I do anything else. I remember this game really bothering me because this guy has like these little noodly arms that were like totally not made to, you know, be hidden by the gauntlets. I don't.
Though 700 years have passed, to my lasting sorrow, the terror continues. It began anew when the shadow wraiths descended on the peaceful village of Overwood. Dark Yabu and his shadow minions drove the defenseless villagers before them, save the ancient guardian of Overwood Vargas and his grandson, Vexx. Defiant but outnumbered.
Yeah, he's got those little noodle arms that's like totally made for hiding in gauntlets, because what is 3D modeling? We don't know how to do that yet.
Slaves. Beaten by word and whip, Vexx endured until his rage became unbearable. He lashed out, attacking his oppressors, but was stopped by the very shadows that answered Yabu's call. Vexx would have died then, were it not for the sacrifice of his grandfather. Enraged, Yabu turned his powers on Vargas and showed no mercy. After nightfall, vowing revenge, Vexx escaped the caves and made his way to the heart of Yabu's windship, intent upon destroying the wraith. Fate, however, would grant him not revenge, but fortune. The legendary Astani War Talons. Unable to destroy the powerful artifact, Dark Yabu had hidden them away for years, fearful that they might fall into enemy hands. Vexx screamed as the Talons bound themselves to him forever, and his fate to that of all a star.
No more jerking off, huh? Play through this GameCube test map. So is that like a mustache or some like fucked sideburns or what's going on there? Alright, you can tell a lot about its game by its swim controls, so let's see. Oh man. But why R? Is it a Ryder kick? No. Oh wow.
Thank you.
Well, it's one of those games where the camera's reversed. Hold on. Oh, shit. Stars? Jiggies? Nah. Hearts. As an aspiring cardiologist, I feel like I should appreciate this game.
You have done well. Beyond this door lies the world in which you alone must use what you have learned to achieve your purpose. Take heart, for the measure of a person lies not in how one deals with the easiest situations, but rather in what you do when faced with the most hopeless of circumstances.
Fuck!
Back among the living, I see. You're a stout one, aren't you? When I found you, I thought you dead, so I brought you here. This chamber is where the past Talon bearers are entombed. Cursed things nearly cut my hands off as I carried you here. Yabu destroyed the village. Everyone is gone except you and old Darby. I'd love to get my hands on that soul-sucking monster, but old Darby can't see so good no more. But you... you could stop him before he opens the door to his world. You could get to the land spire before it's too late. If he opens the rift again, those demons will destroy what little remains of Astara, and all of us with it. Then there'll be nothing to stop the wraiths from using the rift to destroy other worlds. It'll have to be you, my boy. Darby can't...
Oh my god, I can't handle any of this, like, two-bit and shit anymore. Can I just...
Welcome to Timberdale, Vexx. Scattered throughout this land, there are four precious wraith hearts. You must collect them to power up the central gate and progress to the next land. The first wraith heart is found here. You must traverse to the top of the giant tree to collect it. Vexx, collect one of the wraith hearts and I'll meet you on the other side of the central gate.
I miss 3D platforms. Like, did we not just do a tutorial? Mario Sunshine did it, so fuck it, we'll do it too. Oh. Oh shit, I was just gonna crack a joke about being able to, like, stick to the top. See, I was right. This isn't so bad. It's just edgy as hell.
Drained all of the energy from the rift system, couldn't resist feeding on its power.
So this is basically your hub world. So I'll do one better. Before we get to this, hold on. Yeah. Okay. I would play this shit all the time. This game is awesome. I remember unlocking Sonic in this, and it was just like... It's really weird because he's like a third of your size. It's Billy Hatcher. It's Sega's long lost. They had like their own Banjo-Kazooie ripoff on the GameCube, and outside of cameos, it just never gets any love anymore. I'm pretty sure that if I dug around in my mom's closet, I'd be able to find the costume for the dish she made for me. Natural selection? Like, the game or the concept? This game is like half Glover, half Yoshi's Story. Half Banjo-Kazooie. Oh shit! No, that bird's fucking dead. Okay, there's gotta be a switch somewhere to open this up. Yeah. Oh shit! Oops! If I had searched for longer than 2 seconds. And like every other Sega game on the GameCube, this game had the Chao minigame you could download. Whoa, 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 whoa! Okay. Imagine being a grown man and not being able to finish the tutorial in a fucking children's platformer. What the hell? Okay. Fuck that egg. You can hatch unlockables, like lives, health, little pet animals. I think this one's health. No way to protect yourself than an egg, so don't be a dumb fuck. I played it for like 2 seconds to try to get Mel Nettles for Let's Go Eevee, and then I gave the fuck up. Cause I live in buttfuck nowhere, where if I want to play Pokemon Go, I have to like go to a park. And I'm not making special trips just to play a mobile game. Yeah! Oh, I totally forgot you kicked the eggs. Swear to God, things you would only ever say while playing Japanese games, but different eggs have like different favorite foods. So like what works for some eggs might be better with others. Is there a switch? Can a brother get a... Oh, see, that's what I'm saying, man. Fucking Japanese games. Here we go. More stock sound effects! See, he's just making us look like a bitch. That was a hell of a cock. The trinket. Characters in this game were designed by the Sonic artist. So you get these like really oops. You get these like weirdly human You get these like weirdly human Sonic characters. Egg gallery. Years. Let's do some shit from when I was a kid. Where are you at? already having issues. Hello? Okay, so Mega Man 6 was like one of the first. Alright. Nope, not yet! Alright. Just wanted to be a bitch, I guess. So, Mega Man 6 is like a special game to me because. Where I live, we used to have this local game store, and I grew up fairly poor because my biological dad was a piece of shit, and he was basically like, what's that, a kid? I'm out. And sometime around the time I was five, he was like, oh, alright, I guess I'll come back. I always wanted a son. And that's totally not because I'm getting raped by child support. And, so growing up, I liked video games. I had my mom's old Atari I always played. My grandpa had an NES, because he fucking played the shit out of Zelda, like, every single goddamn day. And, if you ever saw the, 4chan posts from, like, a million years ago about some kid playing, Zelda and Metroid with his grandpa, and we used to draw maps and shit on like his military paper and make it look all official and cool. That was me. But so anytime I wanted games, I always got them, like, I either rented all the time or I got them used. And Mega Man 6 was the very first time that I ever got a Mega Man game brand new. So with like the box and the manual and everything. And I treasured the shit out of this game because of that. And, I have every Mega Man game physically. And I have since gone back and, like, bought boxes and manuals and even gone as far as to, like, go to Etsy and get, like, unofficial reprints where they're nice and clean. Just to have, like, nice fresh boxes for my big Mega Man display in my living room. And, I pretty much have this game memorized. My mom and my stepdad were always real protective of me. And, it's like, I had the kind of parents who, my parents embarrassed the shit out of me because I was never allowed to go anywhere, was never allowed to have friends, wasn't till I was able to drive that I could actually get out. So what I would do is I would just sit in my bedroom with my NES and I'd just play fucking Mega Man all day. And, I mean, I would literally just... I would beat this game, reset, beat it again, reset, beat it again. And I think my record is I beat this game in Mega Man 6, specifically Mega Man 6. I think I beat it like 10 times in one day once. Can we not appreciate how I just fucking beat the shit out of Windman like it was nothing? Didn't get hit. (Clears throat) So the story of Mega Man 6 is really cool. It's totally not Dr. Wily in a wig, no sir. But there is a robot competition, a worldwide robot competition, which is more or less a reference to the Mega Man competitions they used to hold all the time in like Nintendo Power. Which, fun fact, the creator of Dust Man from Mega Man 4 and Crystal Man from Mega Man 5 is the artist for One Punch Man. So there's your water cooler topic for the day. But, I used to submit so many Mega Man designs to Nintendo Power. I had one featured, and it was, Spring Man, but not quite a Spring Man. They featured my image in a collage. Because there was, like, the page where it had, like, all the winning kids, and then, before that, there was the, there was just, like, a collage of all the art they submitted, and I got a free Nintendo Power for, like, a year, which was pretty cool. I just love Mega Man. I can play Mega Man all goddamn day. I love Mega Man to the point where it's a problem. I have a rule in my house that I need to be able to play Mega Man no matter what. No matter what system it's on, if I'm sitting in front of some kind of monitor, I need to be able to pick up a controller and be able to play Mega Man on it. So, like, I have a, oh my god, where do I start? I have my R4 card for my DS. Shh, emulation is a bad word, don't say emulation. I have an R4 card on my 3DS. It's for the DS, but I use it on my 3DS. But I have an R4 card with an NES emulator on it, where I have all of the Mega Mans on it. I have the actual Mega Man collection for the 3DS, but before the collection came out, I bought all 6 NES games and all 5 Game Boy games on my 3DS. I have the original Anniversary Collection for GameCube, PS2, and the Xbox. I bought every version. I have the Legacy Collection for PS4, and then I turned around and bought it again on Switch. And then I bought it digitally on Switch. I could go all day. It's ridiculous how many compilations of Mega Man I have. I am personally funding this franchise and keeping it alive. You fuckers are welcome. Oh, get fucked. Nope. Oh well. I always thought those were like little mini versions of Blizzard Man's head, because I was an uncultured fucking farmer child, and I didn't realize that those are supposed to be, the curling salt things from, you know, the Olympics and all that. Is that what that is? Curling? They got the brooms and they're just like... Shh. They have... When I was a kid, I wanted action figures of the Rush Armors so bad. and I never got them. Like, I played with my Ruby Spears Mega Man figures, like, all fucking day and night, and so desperately bad I wanted the Rush Armors. And I used to... This is gonna sound so stupid, but when you're a kid, you make it fucking work. So, the Ruby Spears Rush Mega Man figure had, like these fully flexible limbs and all that. So what I would do is I would put him onto Mega Man like a backpack, and you could pop the legs off just as well as you could pop the because the Mega Man figures all had like a removable arm that you could give to Mega Man. So I would pop the legs off just as well, and I would take my Guts Man figure, and I would give Mega Man the legs and the hand after, like, this abomination of God Rush hanging off of his back setup. What am I doing? I have Mega Man 6 down to a science, so I'm probably going to end up beating this before the stream's over. See? Never puss out and use an E-Tank unless you absolutely think you have to, because you never know. You might not actually need to use it. Mm. God damn it, Mordecai. Hello. I used to have so much trouble with Plant Man when I was a kid. I would save it for the absolute last. And I don't know what it is about this level that would always fuck me over, but it just did. But yeah, every single level takes place in a different part of the world, and the American translation actually removed these and changed it, but the, but I know. I'll know forever. I can tell you every single stupid-ass plot point about Mega Man ever. Like, did you know Mega Man himself has a weakness? Mega Man himself is weak to electricity. It consistently does huge damage to him every time. And Mega Man himself is solar powered. And hey, just in time, your healing items are these like light emitting batteries. Hey, all I'm saying is, if you don't do the claw when you play Mega Man, are you even fucking playing Mega Man? But, no, back to what I was trying to say. Every single level in this game takes place in a different part of the world. So, Windman is from China. Flame Man is from Saudi Arabia. Blizzard Man is from Canada, and Plant Man here is from Africa. I don't know why Nintendo thought they should remove, you know, the educational aspects. I'm being a shit. There's nothing educational about this. But yeah, it was always this part that fucked with me as a kid. So you gotta be really careful when you're fighting Plant Man, because you have just enough blizzard blasts to hit him with. Also, I blow people's minds with this every time, but every single Robot Master in Mega Man 6 has the exact same pattern. Jump, attack. Jump, attack. Without fail. And there you have it. There's a, back to what I was saying, the jet adapter reminded me. Oh Jesus, whoops. There's actually, so there were full size, I believe they were either Kotobukiya or, I think Kotobukiya is who does all of the Mega Man figures. Because Good Smile handles the Nendoroids, but, yeah, they made a set where it was the Dash and, or Dash, what the hell am I saying? The Jet and the, Power Armor that you could buy, but it was like $300. And I wasn't getting my sweet grant money at the time. And, they've got a new set out now. Where they're like miniature figures, and they've got a it's a set where it's Mega Man X, Cut Man, the Power Armors, Mega Man X, Vile. I don't know if they're selling them individually or, but I know you can buy them as a set. And I did. And you can get a set of Power Armor. Or not the Power Armor, the Right Armor. So you can get the, you can get X's Right Armor, one of the generic Right Armor suits from, X1, and you can get Vile's Right Armor suit, too. His fucking, like, sexy legs when he uses the jetpack will always crack me up. I always like doing this to show off. Ah, I landed. They loved this so goddamn much, they put it on the box art. And I don't blame them, because the fucking armors are awesome. That's what I... That's what I hate about, and don't worry, we're coming back. But that's what I hate about, the modern Mega Man games. They took the right armor. They took your armors away. And, the worst part is Mega Man 11, because I'm baffled that game has nothing. Hold on. My dogs are freaking out about something. Mordecai, you little dick. Did you spill your water? Okay. I'm back. This family coming over for a minute. Now we gotta loop back around. Because we need beat. And you find the beat parts in the later four levels that you go to. The levels that are marked with Mega Man's face after you clear them don't have a beat part, but the other four levels do. And it's really just a matter of finding an alternate path. And this is about the most exciting that the alternate paths get. And you will see as we do the last three levels. You have to be careful with Tomahawk Man because he will eat your plant barrier if you don't use it just right. Also, holy shit. I don't know what unfunny asshole wrote the achievements for this game, but they can suck a dick. Also, let's all take a moment to appreciate this a Tanuki shooting balls. Thank you. Oh, damn it. See, the best compilation Mega Man game will always be Anniversary Collection on the GameCube, because they mapped the rush suits to the C-stick, and you could just, like, flick it and instantly change. So Tomahawk Man is the American Robot Master in this game, coming from Texas. And now we're on Yamato Man, and I want you to take a wild fucking guess who, or where you think Yamato Man comes from. And considering this level started with Mount Fuji in the background, you get three guesses, and the first two don't count. And a really neat thing about getting the beat parts is that it changes the palette of the level after, for some reason. And some of the levels look really nice, some of them... Like Yamato Man's level changes purple. Well, there goes that one. I don't understand that. There's gotta be some, like, mythos, or Japanese mythos or something, because I genuinely don't understand this, like, oh, I threw my spearhead! Oh, my mama got me that spearhead, I gotta go get it! Oh well. Now we're off to jolly old Britland. I rewatched the Austin Pat. What the fuck was that? Oh, hey, cool. I got spooked by my own shit. Alright, now watch this suddenly jerk back up as you realize this is a NES sprite trick. Ta-da! It's a background layer. Thank you. But it's a background layer trick to get that shit to work. It's so fascinating to go back to the Mega Man games and to just, like, start from the beginning in 1987, and 6 was 1993 or 1994. But to just, like, oh, shit! I think that was my first death, actually. But, you can actually use the Mega Man games as a timeline to chart all the cool shit developers learned how to do. Because since there were so goddamn many of them. I always love how you pop them in the head and they're just like, hey. I love these little guys. They have like their little graduation caps and then, bah! What do you mean my education was worthless? Alright, the branching off point for where the beat part is in this level is coming up. You gotta be really careful. You might miss it. Okay, so here's the boss. I wonder where the alternate path is. Boy, this was rough. I sure hope I didn't miss it. Honestly, the worst one is Centaur Man. And if you haven't seen that, you're in for it. Okay, so going back to what I talked to earlier when I was playing Network Transmission. About the, some of the Battle Network designs got the short end of the stick. Nightman had to be the worst. Because it was just a goddamn castle. Let me grab it real quick. Oh no, so they did go back and make a Nightman. Well, I stand corrected. But there's some dumb shit in Battle Network. And I remember very clearly there was a net navy that was just straight up a fucking castle. Alright, now we wait. Pop. You know what I miss? The Rush Marine. I always loved playing on the water levels again, just to mess around with the Rush Marine. Whoop, whoop. A lot of people think that Astro Boy is the only inspiration for Mega Man, and you're not entirely wrong, but part of the draw of Tatsunoko vs. Capcom on the Wii was going back and like pointing out how many of the Tatsunoko characters indirectly attributed to Mega Man. Like one of my favorite animes is the original Kashurn, and Friender, who was Kashurn's dog, inspired Rush, as well as the robot enemies in Mega Man 2 that were just straight up called Friender. But yeah, if you ever watched Kashurn, and I'm not talking about like the gritty early 2000s reboot, which is also good, but like the original 70s Kashurn, where, you know, got to reuse that animation like Hanna-Barbera, and every episode has Kashurn doing like 10 backflips. Someone out there is screaming that I keep saying Kashurn instead of Kashan, but it's my stream. But in the original 70s Kashurn, that fucking dog turned into everything. So here's the real path, but fuck that. We want beat. We're gonna get beat. Where's it at? There it is. I always like to rationalize the weapon weaknesses, because it's just a lot of fun to do, and this is always my least favorite one, because I can't think of anything that it could possibly be besides, like, breaking his fucking legs with a mace. Oh, I was so close to no damage, bitch. Got in like one cheap shot. You ever think that the, I just look at some of these Wily castles, and I can't help but wonder how Wily always has, like, 20 castles laying around. Does he recycle? Does he, like, pick up the scraps of old castles that Mega Man destroys? Does he... Is it, like, in the future, can they, like, convert dirt into raw ores, or... Is it concrete? How come he only ever has the one set of cannons? Oh! Oh, jeez. Alright, this is gonna be the part where I die a million times. Because I always like to show off that I can get into this little... Oh! First try! Fucking happy birthday! And this is the part where they just give up. Well, it's not so much giving up as it is congratulations, you got in, but... Bam! 4 1-ups. Always have to bitch out and use a fucking E-tank here, and I don't want to. Huh! Huh! Oh god! Okay. Good lord, you can, like, compress coal in my fucking asshole right now and make a diamond. Now, quick! Was there two of those drill bots there? Or is it just like loading in a second one because of a funky NES dithering? That part exists just to be like, fuck you, you can't finish the game without a suit. Once upon a time, I want to say somebody was making a ROM hack to, like, add in the Yomu blocks, but I don't think that ever came to be. That's the path to the E-Tank. One of these days I will remember. There we go. Sometimes I wonder if the reason that the Wily Castle stages always feature like every Mega Man enemy ever is because the locations in the ROM bank. I could go down that bottom path, but ain't nobody got time for that. Besides, why do that to yourself when you can do this? The only thing down there is one of the blocks has an E-tank in it anyway, so. And that's why you keep your jet suit on in this level. What did I do? Oh, God. I could be a bitch and blame my button on my controller sticking, but I'm a bigger man than that. I made stupid decisions and paid the price. You know what I've never understood? How do people have trouble with, like, buttons on a controller? Because I see these threads on like 4chan all the time where people complain about like, oh, game says press X. What do you do? Like, how do you not have a controller memorized in like 2 seconds? I guess is what I'm trying to say. Like, especially like a what is it? The Xbox controller is just the Dreamcast controller. Nintendo has, like, relatively stayed the same. Like, the GameCube controller was funky, but like, the only time Nintendo has ever been different was the 64 controller. Because, and somebody's going to argue the Wiimote, but the Wiimote Classic Controller still follows the, SNES Abixi. I call it Abixi. But, I don't know. I've never had a situation in my life where, I've been playing a video game and forgot what button on the controller was what. Like, I may refer to buttons as other buttons. I don't know. I've just never had the trouble, is what I'm trying to say. I mean, especially when you think about it as, like, the PlayStation controller has been the same forever until the PS4. Because you can't mess with perfection, baby. Oof. Usually I always die there. I don't think they had a name. I think it was just Evil Beat. So I learned something interesting on this new YouTube channel I started watching. So I've always been confused by, like, certain parts about, like, retro games, and like, I always thought something was wrong or something was broken, like when I got when I bought my launch Wii U, like the fucking idiot I am. Alright, I'm invincible! No! Oh. Oh, that was almost a problem. But no, like, when I bought my launch Wii U, like, fucking moron I am. And they had their, like, 30th anniversary where they were selling NES games and Super Nintendo games for 30 cents. One a month! Thanks, Nintendo! I may have to use a tank. Is this the remastered one? Nope. Fouled. But fucking Mets punch their skulls in. Alright, can I hit the fucking secret path here too? Yes, I can. Sweet. But no, I was subscribed to this new channel on YouTube where they the guy talks about, like, little tricks and shit for retro games. and I always used to think that it was like a broken emulator or like a bad dump of a game. And I was playing like Kirby's Adventure or something, and like the colors on one side of the screen would all be fucked. Do you see how on the left side of the screen there's a black bar constantly there? Now look on the right side of the screen, where as the game goes, you can see sprites and textures being loaded in. That's actually happening on the left side as well, but they block it with black bars. And it's because they have enough space in the sprite memory to be able to do that. But if they were to do it on the right side as well, then they would not be able to have as detailed sprites, because it'd be taking away from sprite layers. And that's just... I don't know, there's just something really interesting about that. And it was hidden by CRTs at the time. So, like, unlike today where we play on flat screens, on rounded screens, all this went away. First E-Tank of the game. And then I proceeded to not get hit anyway. That's cool. Oh shit, oh shit. Ah, that's what I get. I always take the frozen path. Just this one time, to be special, I'd like to not take the frozen path. Go, go, go! Oof. I don't think it's actually possible to get that life without letting yourself get hit. Oh, I'm sorry, did a boss come into the room? Did anybody see the boss? as a kid, I was always rationing like one E-tank per boss, and now it's just like, yeah, fuck it, yep, Nightman, yep, yum, Centaur Man, yep, time to break his fucking kneecaps, yep. So can someone explain how the Centaur Flash hurts Windman? Is it because he's Chinese and all that light is too much for his squinty old eyes? It's bad. I think that's the most racist joke I've cracked on a Mega Man stream. I think that honor goes to screaming, "Not today, Red Man!" When I killed Tomahawk Man at like 1 HP the last time I played this. Oh, I made someone leave. We couldn't take it. You know, I can't even drink for my fucking birthday because I gotta open in the morning. Bullshit. You know, speaking of having to do funky things to my Ruby Spears figures to bullshit having the armors, I can't believe, because I saw this on the show, and even as a kid, I knew. It's like, oh man, that's an accessory just waiting to come. The episodes where Mega Man had his, like, flight armor and the dive armor. I cannot believe. Maybe it's because the toys got canceled, like, prematurely when the show got canceled. But I can't believe those never were figures. I always like to fight this last form with the Mega Buster. Oh, nope. Give me my sip. You know what's the one thing I didn't like about Mega Man 11? And this is gonna sound so stupid. I don't like that they made all the different tanks different colors. So like the weapon tank is yellow and the mystery tank is red. I didn't like that. Because there was a level in Mega Man 10, I think, where it was, you were upside down, so one of the tanks was upside down. And so it's like, oh boy, a mystery tank. No, it's a weapon tank. But then later in the level, you're like, oh boy, a weapon tank, and it's actually the mystery tank. Two E-tanks and one boss, I'm so ashamed. Okay, now this button is like legitimately sticking. I'm pretty sure he's weak tonight. I'm getting tired of waiting for him. There we go. I just really like this song. Sorry, guys. Here, let's, play another NES game I got for my birthday. Shit. Oh wow. Good enough. I'm decent at puzzle games. Don't fuck with me. I really liked Yoshi as a kid, so my mom basically got everything Yoshi she could find for me. Come on. Yeah, boy. I always used to wonder what these damn cookies were as a kid, because I'd never seen any like that in my life, but those like checkerboard ones, and then you see them everywhere in manga, and you're like, oh, it's like weird Japanese shit. Don't get me wrong, I love weird Japanese shit, but... There we go, damn. Be here all goddamn day! Shit. I should have thought this out more. Yeah, that's right, fuck off! Shit, it touched. Oh boy. Oh. Okay, I ain't playing this shit all fucking day. What's another game I got? Once my mom got a really good job, she used to just, like, fucking throw games at me. I was really spoiled as a kid once my mom started making some good money. Trust me. Trust me. I've been paying her back. Don't worry about it. I bought my mom all kinds of, like, good shit to make up for it. So, yeah, it turned out good. I'm basically just going through this list until I see, like, a game like, oh, I got that. It's, yeah. There was a game that you could tell. I mean, I can't fault my grandparents for it. It's not like my grandparents grew up with video games. But there was a game where my grandparents just got it for me, and you could just tell they bought it just because it looked cool. And... bless him for it, but you know what? I just saw one. I am gonna through a loophole. Because my grandma got me one of those shitty fucking hollowed out SNES or Nintendo 64 controllers with like the 50,000 Chinese ripoff games on it. And this was on there. So I am counting this. Fuck you. Where'd it go? Where'd it go? Come on, there it is. I'm counting this. Oh man, who do I want to be? I'll stick with Kaneko Man. And I want Ramen Man as... Oh shit! Oh no! Kaneko Man, let's do this. Oh shit. Oh yeah, get some. Oh, rapid fire, I'm cheating, rapid fire. Oh, come on, yeah, tag in dad. Get back here. I am a champion. Okay, yep, that was fun. All right. Let's move on to another console. I know some games that I got for other game systems. So this is a fun one. You either know this or you don't. And all right, come on. Why are we being shy? Come on. Oh, it was made by Sunsoft? That's fucking cool. Come on, where are you at? I used to play this all the time, but I could never get my cartridge to save, and the passwords never fucking worked either. I'm gonna just stick with the main character. There it is. Hold on. There it is, the battle music. Oh, yeah. Fighting games on Game Boy. There we go. Fucked. There it is. Piston punch. And you buy the parts to power up the your ability to do specials. So like, you can always do the special, but like you can't do your super special. I think this kid like cries like a bitch when you win too. I used to play with this one too, just because I thought he looked cool. Oh God. Oh, he might actually win. Aha! He's no match for my diagonal jumping punch attack. Oh, he got me. Or did he? No, he got me. Let's... Let's do some other games I've got. I mean, yeah, I'm going down the list till I see something I recognize getting for my birthday. Oh my god, yeah. Ow, what'd you do? Come on. Game was the shit when I was a kid. I'm so upset my dogs killed my... Here, gotta be accurate. Okay, good. Turbo works on this. Oh man, what was his name? Boss? And I think the little girl was voiced by Laura Bailey. I'm gonna like turbo through this because nobody wants to watch fucking bullshit tutorial shit. I think we got enough of that out of Vexx. Thank you. I used to drive my dad fucking crazy because I'd play this on my Game Boy player on the GameCube. Oh, it's Bijou. So fucking cute, I'm gonna get goddamn diabetes. It saves automatically when you leave an area. It's been fun today, but it's been almost 3 fucking hours, and I've left my dogs alone for too long. I can only imagine what my living room looks like. Alright. If there are any games that you'd like to see me finish, just go ahead and let me know. But be gone. Yeah, if there were any games you'd like to see me finish, let me know. Otherwise, some of these I might just pick back up on my own anyway. There is one major game I did not play today, because it's one for sure I know it's something I want to stream in the future, and that is Phantasy Star for the GameCube. Phantasy Star Online, even. So, have a good day. Got a ton of people watching today, which is a lot of fun. I'll be back soon with more Summon Night.